Both teams come into this one riding high after back-to-back wins. Mr. Vitale, this third-round game should prove to be a tight one between the Eastern Washington Eagles and the Texas Tech Red Raiders.
Both teams need to forget about the wild crowd here and play basketball.
The Red Raiders should be able to run away with this one, Dick Vitale.
Hey, what are the keys for them doing so? The keys are pretty simple, Brad. First of all, don't let the other team dictate the tempo and the pace. Play at your speed, baby. Second of all, don't let their big man become a factor offensively. Keep him off the block, push him away from the low box, and force him to shoot jump shots. Lastly, execute defensively. Don't get caught going for the big steals or the big blocks.
I couldn't agree more with you, partner. Let's get down to the court and join the action. Nicky's worked at his shot block. Both teams are looking to get something going here. For the bucket, the lay-in.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. He stays in control until they regroup the offense. Now trying to feed the low block. Here's the offensive drop step in the low block, but better defense.
I tell you, the defense doesn't allow him to get to the baseline.
I tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet, fading away, impossible to block.
Trying to go inside.
And they do. They got him the low block. Makes the move and goes up strong, but that's an offensive foul. Dude.
He's out of control, baby. Out of control.
They go into the low block. Number 34, pump fakes. He goes with a baby hook. Dick, they're ripping up the nets tonight.
Hey, they're definitely shooting the ball well tonight. Great execution by these boys.
On the dribble, gives it up.
I'll tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box.
Tries a three. Off the rim and no good. Moving it around the perimeter. Great steal. I think the pressure was just too much.
Tremendous pressure. Just enough to force the steal.
Down inside. Dickey's going to kick it back and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Trying to feed the low block. He attempts a jump hook. Can't get the shot to go. Dick, not a bad drop step, but it doesn't work for him.
I tell you, just doesn't beat him to the basket, not quick enough. And a great reaction by the defensive post player.
Dick, a great battle down in the low post, but I think the offense is gaining ground here.
Yeah, he's getting great inside position, has the great angle. He's got him set up perfectly for a basket. They get the 45-degree angle, which is essential in entering the ball to the post.
Number 45 takes the pass. That spin move not successful, Dick.
I tell you, great job on the defense, not allowing him to make that turn.
Number 42 picks up the foul. First personal foul. The center gets the pass. Number 42 grabs it. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Looking for a good shot.
The frustration right there.
The center gets the ball. Our three-prong attack tonight, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Brad Nessler with Dick Vitale. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot. Dump it inside.
The center takes the feed. Ball was loose, but the offense got it back. the point guard with the ball. Gave it up. Trying to stay with him defensively. Down he goes.
Oh, what an acting job. There's no doubt in my mind he's flopping, baby.
Looking for a good shot. Jumped in front to take it away. They work it around the perimeter. In the paint. Tries for two. Perfectly executed. He keeps his dribble as they reset. And a momentary look from three-point land. Here's a double team. He takes it away. Showing maturity by waiting for the O to regroup. On the outside. There's a high screen. For two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in. Then a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Let's see if they can get a good shot this trip. For the bucket, in and out. Goes up for two. What should they do here, Dick?
I'd call a timeout and see what's going on out there. There's definitely some miscommunication happening.
Didn't like what he saw in the post and reverses the ball. On the inside, number 50 takes it away. Patience with the ball as the offense regroups.
That was really a nonchalant pass. Get that sucker out of the game, man.
Dick, how's he working him defensively?
I'll tell you, he's trying to front right now. You've got three concepts. You can play halfway, you can play behind, or in front. They've decided to play in front, which means you got to get help side.
Three. That's not a good shot given his abilities.
Yeah, that's horrible, Mr. Nestler. Horrible shot selection.
He's got to get rid of it. Down he goes, and no foul called either way.
Wow, no call. I can't believe that one.
And the ball goes out of play. Oh, that's going to be a costly turnover there.
I'll tell you, turnovers could absolutely destroy a team. Great anticipation defensively.
Overplays on the pass, and he didn't get the steal.
Oh, he's humiliated. Poor job defensively. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards up there.
Yeah, that helps. Texas Tech have a nice little run going here. Can they keep it up, though?
No one's proven otherwise just yet, Brad. I think right now, got to focus defensively.
And he scores despite the hack. Going to move it around the perimeter. On the dribble, gives it up. Leaning in, trying to draw contact.
Block shot usually creates momentum and opportunity.
Ouch! That's what I call a hard screen.
I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
Pass down low. There's a drop step, and oh, good defense.
I thought defense reacted and beat him to the spot. Very poor job with the drop step. Very slow.
They'll work it around the arc, in the paint. Jumps in. He keeps the concentration off the contact for the score. They work it around the perimeter. Entry pass in the paint.
Coach looks on. Focused, a lot of intensity, a lot of emotion.
Way off target. Moving it around the perimeter. Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Brad and Dick, I'm down here by the losing team's bench. Their coaching staff is reminding them, look, it's just your nerves. Relax. It's only the first half. This team feels once they've settled in, they can take over here in the first half.
The ball goes out of bounds. Looking for a good shot. Trying to draw the foul. Texas Tech have put together somewhat of a run here.
Maintaining is the key, though. They've got to continue to make the hustle plays at both ends of the court. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Dick, not a bad drive. There's a nice block from behind, Dick.
Yeah, that's good timing for the defense.
Goes in. Fake. Had him in the low block, but opted against it. Lets it fly. He's clearly forcing things right now, Dick.
He's taking his team out of the game.
He sinks another basket. What are they going to do with this guy, Dick?
I don't know, Brad, but they better do it quickly.
And, Dick, this is just playing good defense.
Really does a great job with his footwork, beating him to the spot.
Unloads a three. Poor decision there to shoot that three.
Yeah, I'm not sure what he was thinking there.
Both teams looking to get things going here. He strips him clean. Fast break opportunity here. On the outside. He shoots from the top of the key. Gets it to fall. At the three. He's typically a good shooter.
Yeah, but not tonight. He's got to accept that.
Got it. He gets the foul and the bucket.
That's how you do it when you want to win, baby.
What a play. These kids are fired up now. And if you're going to celebrate, why not celebrate with a teammate?
I'd celebrate too, partner. They are playing some great basketball at the moment.
Routine.
Pressure that basketball, help one another, communicate.
And he's going to pick up the foul, and oh, look at the look on his face.
I'll tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach.
Shoots it. It'd be nice if he could get some assistance out there. That young man is doing it all for his team right now.
He's a one-man show at the moment. He can't get any help from his teammates. Up and inside.
Way out on top. Controlling the ball. From beyond the arc. Not this time. Tries for two. They still don't score. Here's Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
He does the sweet fake shot, and he'll kick it back outside. For two, and he missed. Looking to move it around the perimeter. Fronts him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And they made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
Gave it up. Fakes it.
Pushing that basketball.
And one too many dribbles and a steal.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set.
Great block shot. On the dribble, gives it up. That spin move not successful, Dick.
I tell you, great job on the defense, not allowing him to make that turn. Let's see if they go two for one here, Brad.
They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
Dickie's doing a nice job defensively fronting him.
Well, it's the key is to really beat him to the spot, get help from the help side, and really do a great job seeing ball and man.
Steals the ball. Shot clock is dead. Turns it over. Pushes it up. Jumps into the defender. Perfectly executed.
Wow, can we get slow-mo, please?
It around the arc, fires away. He's taken too many unnecessary shots, Dick.
And he's costing his team their rhythm.
From center court, misses from beyond the three-point line. At the end of the first half, the Red Raiders are up by four. Texas Tech has made a statement by crashing the boards in the first half, Dick.
Very, very strong statement. They're letting the opposition know that they're not going to give them any second chance opportunities. And that speaks volumes, baby.
Dick, these kids have battled through a first half. They battled through an entire season and their conference tournaments. And now it's down to who's got some gas left in the tank.
I tell you what, momentum's so important. You got to try to go on a little spurt now. Because anybody who gets the lead is really putting the pressure on the club that would be behind.
Dickie's still applying great pressure on the dribbler. Shot from the baseline. Off the rim and no good. Work it inside and he tries a drop step. Defensively, nice job.
Great job using his footwork defensively to beat him to the spot.
The fake. Gets the feed down low. Now the turnaround jumper. Rims out. Dumps it in. Intercepted. The center receives the pass. Swatted from behind.
Never saw him coming, Brad.
Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter. Dick, not a bad drop step, but it doesn't work for him.
I tell you, just doesn't beat him to the basket. Not quick enough. And a great reaction by the defensive post player.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in, and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Dickey's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing, he's trying to deny him the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing him off.
We'll take the shot. Eastern Washington are doing a nice job of putting a solid run together here.
Hey, they're really starting to click on offense.
They work it around the perimeter.
He didn't have the good angle. They should have got it to him about a second earlier.
Grabs it.
Men have got to get out and fill the lanes, Brad.
On the outside, picked out of the air, and the ball goes out of bounds. And there's a look at the backcourt comparison, Dick.
I tell you, Brad, you always want to know how the primary ball handlers are doing. Are they getting their team's quality shots, good opportunities? The team which takes care of these things usually is in a better position to win a game.
The center handles the feed. Now he faces up on the low block.
I think it's great when you got a post player that can face up on a defensive player and attack the basket.
He shoots from left of the circle. Picks off the lazy pass. He's got a nice shot fake.
Get that sucker out of the game, man.
They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside outside action always works.
Way off target. For the bucket. Can't get the shot to drop. Up. Easy one. Another look. He unloads a three. He gets it to go. Number five is called for the foul. I've seen you out there with pom-poms, Mr. Vitale, but not looking that good.
I'll tell you what, don't look that good. I can't dance like that, baby. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Gave it up. The shooting guard handles the pass. Now they work it around the perimeter. He shoots from the top of the circle. Misses from downtown. Problem with that, when you front, if you don't get some backside help, you're in trouble.
Well, you got to get help because you got to see ball, man. That's essential when you play out there and you front it.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
He shoots from long range. Sinks it. Working it around the perimeter. Steals the pass. He shoots from downtown. Off the rim and no good. On the dribble, gives it up.
Double team now, bad angle.
He takes it away. Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Trying to draw some contact. Sweet looking shot.
He is super. He really is.
They'll work it around the arc. He pump fakes. Tough spot defensively in the post, but he got the steal.
Wow, I could have made that steal. He telegraphed that. He was the Marconi guy. What a poor pass. Set that screen away.
looking for a good shot. He looks for three. That's definitely not the shot they were looking for, Dick.
Hey, Brad, their shot selection has been questionable. Too many outside jumpers. They've got to attack inside and then out.
For the bucket. Rims out. On the outside, the power forward receives the ball. Puts it up, looking for contact. We'll see who's got more coming out of this timeout as play resumes. He dials long distance. Off the rim and no good.
Up and inside.
For two, Eastern Washington is showing a bit of a run here.
Things are going their way right now. Great play to take that to the basket.
Dick, a great battle down in the low post, but I think the offense is gaining ground here.
Yeah, getting great inside position, has the great angle. He's got him set up perfectly for a basket. They got the 45-degree angle, which is essential in entering the ball to the post.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in, and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
I don't think that's the guy they want shooting that shot.
Man, I can guarantee you that he's not the guy they want shooting the ball.
In the paint. Good fake. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with the block shot.
Off the rim and no good. Dickey's really sticking to his man defensively down there.
I tell you, doing a great job fronting him, trying to beat him to the spot, playing in front, making him throw the lob pass over the top. If you get help, you can take that pass away.
The ball goes out of play. Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Erin.
Well, Brad and Dick, the crowd certainly hoped for a closer matchup. One side of the arena is celebrating in the stands, and the other one is just sitting there in complete disbelief, guys.
Thanks, Erin. Decided against the open post and reverses the ball. Goes up for two. They still don't score. Now they work it around the perimeter. Gave it up. Ball was tipped loose, but the offense retains possession.
Rebounding is such an effort thing. Getting to the glass, blocking out. There aren't enough good rebounding teams in the nation.
He shoots from long range. Way off target. What a brilliant defensive effort by this bunch tonight, Dick.
Hey, this is how you play team defense, baby.
Had him in the post and didn't pass it in. Reverses it. And the ball goes out of play. Ball comes back out from the post and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Number 34 picks up the defensive foul. First personal foul. The Red Raiders will step to the line for the first time. Gets the first shot. Two at the charity stripe. gives it up. He attempts the trifecta. He gets that one to fall. He goes up strong, and that's going to be an offensive foul.
Oh, great call by the official. He beat him to the spot. That's essential defensively. High post screen. I'll tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box. Nice high post screen.
That was nice. He looks for three. Rims out. He tries the jumper. Off the rim and no good. Basket falls despite the contact. Picks off the pass. Looking for the foul. Drops the bucket despite the harm. Looking for a screen on top and got it. Rims out. Spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
He tries the three ball. Eastern Washington are on a nice little run at the moment.
Hey, that'll keep pushing and seeing if they can't force a timeout.
Boy, it's all elbows and shoulders down there, and I think the defense is winning, Dick.
I tell you, doing a great job of post defense. A lot of people don't realize that is an area that has to be taught, and this kid has responded in a positive way.
Here's the offensive drop step and a low block, but better defense.
I tell you, the defense doesn't allow him to get to the baseline.
They're going to need a miracle to get a victory in this one now.
Yeah, now it's about damage control. Good time to get some of the bench players into the game to avoid injury.
Puts it on the floor and up and under.
I tell you, did a great job creating a good angle, too. When he goes up and under, he seals off the defensive player.
He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post player.
Here's a block from behind.
My man was on a mission.
He squares up down on the low block.
I tell you, teach your player to face up to get in triple threat position. You can drive, shoot, or you can pass. Timeout, Brad. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
With the fake. Down low, puts it on the floor. Turn around, fadeaway. No good. With the board.
Fill the lanes. That's the only way to be able to get some fast break opportunities.
Strips the ball. Hard foul. Oh, and he's not going to be happy with that call.
Well, silly foul right there, but look at his face. His facial expression tells it all.
shoots from the top of the circle. He gets the bucket to fall. That's a matter of clock management, isn't it, Dick?
Now it's a matter of clock management, Brad. They have to foul in order to be able to get to that winner's circle.
And they continue to foul to stop the clock. And we get a look here at our foul and timeout situation.
Hey, Brad, many games are lost because coaches fail to manage the clock. Possession or timeout situation. Let's see how these coaches fare tonight.
They work it back to the outside. They're working around the perimeter. He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post play.
This is the big time. Off the rim and no good. From way outside. And he misses the shot. All right, Dick, this one's over. One team moves on. One team's got to go home, and that's the sad part about the NCAA tournament.
Well, the better team won because they protected the basketball. They made sure they converted on the free throw line. They did all the little intangibles we talked about, and that was the difference in the game.
Eastern Washington makes it three in a row with an impressive third-round victory.
Hey, the way they're playing, Brad, this team is going to be hard to deal with entering the Elite Eight.
It's been a fun game, and as always, my partners alongside have enjoyed you being with us. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler. Good night, everybody.